What is up, guys? It's your boy Dark Knight back for another video. Today is April 25th. It is about 5:22 right now. And right now, we're going to be watching Endgame. Honestly, I have so many questions about this movie. I hope I'm not going to cry too much. But right after this movie, I doubt I'm going to be watching any more Marvel movies after this. Because I think this is going to be the last Marvel movie I'll ever watch. Maybe I might watch Black Widow. Maybe. But for now, it's time for Endgame. So we're heading towards the theater. We're already here. One second. Shit. So many expectations for this movie, man. I'm gonna probably go in blindingly, not know anything. I'm not gonna predict anything. It's just gonna be me alone.
Let's go. What are you doing?
Vlogging. So let's go into it. Here we go. Toby, what are you going to, what can you expect for,
I don't know what to expect.
Really?
Alright. No, no, no.
So let's, end it right here. So, what did I think about Avengers Endgame? Masterpiece. I think I almost cried. I won't tell you about the movie. Honestly, this movie was epic. And I think it is the best movie of all time. It's the best comic book movie of all time. Don't argue with me, don't at me. Bro, Endgame is the best. If I have to rewatch it again, I want to rewatch it again. Yo, it's too epic. But I think this may be the last Marvel movie I'll be watching for a while, because I don't know if I'm going to be watching Spider-Man or Captain America. I'm saying Captain America, freaking Captain Marvel, or Black Panther. It's always the original. I always watch till the day I die. So guys, what do you think about the movie? Guys, Hedish, what do you think about the movie? What do you think about the movie, guys?
Dope.
Yo, guys, what do you think about the movie?
Tony Stark dies.
That's cool. Yo, best movie of all time.
Yo, subscribe to this guy.
Crush Task Force, come on, he's stupid, he's dumb.
Yo, but still, this is actually...
You gotta edit that. You don't put the... When I...
Yo, black it out. Nice.
Yo.
What is up, guys? It's your boy Dark Knight back for another video. I just came back from watching Avengers Endgame. It is now 11:13. So many words I can explain about this movie. Without a doubt, this is the best comic book movie ever made of all time. You can compare it to Dark Knight, to Dark Knight Rises, Batman v Superman, which we're not going to even compare that movie to that, or any other Marvel or DC movie in the world. Endgame was the best movie of all time. I'm not gonna spoil anything, but there's so many reasons why this movie was the best of all time. The story was amazing. The action scenes were great. The idea of these characters doing whatever it takes to bring everything back from what Thanos did. It was truly heartbreaking. It was emotional. It was something that no other movie could ever pull off. If I had to rate this movie from a scale of 1 to 10, I rate this movie a 10. Masterpiece. Because there is no other movie ever in the world that can actually beat this movie. And I'm thinking in my head, like, what can Marvel do to top Endgame? And honestly, there's nothing, or there's no movie in this world that can actually top Endgame. This is such an emotional ride. I mean, we've been through it all. I mean, 11 years in the making. I mean, I remembered watching Iron Man for the first time, and I never knew who Iron Man was, because I didn't really get into a lot of the Marvel stuff, because the only Marvel hero that I knew was Spider-Man. And I enjoyed watching the Tobey Maguire trilogy with Spider-Man's 1, 2, and 3. 1 and 2 were the best, 3 was like, meh. They were going to make Spider-Man 4, but it was canceled. So I'm like, okay. Then Iron Man comes out. And I'm thinking, this is a Marvel movie. I hope it's like Spider-Man. Honestly, I didn't expect it to be like Spider-Man. Matter of fact, it was so different that it became something so unique. And then all of a sudden, Iron Man spawns another new movie, which is The Incredible Hulk. And you see Tony Stark in the end credit scene, and you know, they're talking to he's talking to Ross about the Avengers initiative, and then the movie goes into Iron Man 2, and then you see him talking with Nick Fury, and then you see Thor, and then basically all these movies wrapping up into one massive movie coming in 2012, and that was the first Avengers movie. And then into a brand new universe of different movies coming out, even shows that are pretty much connected to the Marvel Cinematic Universe. See, this is why Marvel is better than DC. I mean, I love DC. I love Batman, and I love The Flash, and I love Superman. I love the DC comics. But what the DC Extended Universe is doing that the Marvel Universe has already done is that they made a plan. DC, they make a plan, but they always change it. They say they're going to make a movie, the next scene later, scheduling, freaking contracts, and then pretty much everything is messed up. That's why Justice League was not the good movie. Avengers was always going to be better. Because it doesn't matter if Batman's going to be there, Superman's going to be there, Flash is going to be there, it doesn't even matter. At the end of the day, whatever they do, their planning is always off. But you see Avengers, and you see all these amazing actors, both Oscar nominees, Oscar winners, all these unique different characters all into this one movie to give us the epic trilogy finale of all time. And quite honestly, I am really proud to finally go to this movie and not see anything or see any spoilers. I wanted to go into the movie expecting this movie to be great. Alright, I went in, I didn't do my research, I didn't look up anything, I didn't see no TV spots, I don't see nothing. I was off that. I don't care if they release a clip from the movie, it doesn't matter. I am off that. I don't want to see anything like that. And when I went into the theaters, I expected a lot. And guess what? I did. And honestly, it was such an amazing ending for the movie, and I may have cried in the movie. I'm sorry, I may have cried during the movie, but I'm admitting it. But this is a movie that is worth watching over and over and over again. Marvel, you made Stan Lee proud, and I respect that. If you guys like this review, leave a like down below. Tell me what else I should react to or review. And I'll see you guys in my next video. Peace.